Okay, let's look at SPP. This is still paper one. Okay, tahun 2020. Okay, it is given that 1 m square m power 4 are the first three consecutive terms. Tiga sebutan pertama berturutan. In English, when you see the word consecutive, okay, that means it's like next to each other. Okay, contohlah. Like in this case, m square, m4 kan. So that means this is T1. This is T2, T3. That means it is berjiran. They are neighbors. If sometimes they mention not consecutive, that means they are not neighbors. Dia tak berturutan. Okay. Find the sum to infinity. Okay. Sum to infinity means kena guna which formula? Like this, right? Sum to infinity, you have to use this formula. So you have to use A over 1 minus R. Okay, let's identify kita punya A dulu lah. A is the first term lah. So happen to be here, our first term is 1. Okay, R. R is common ratio. Beza sepunya. So you have to take the second term bahagi the first term. So let me take M square bahagi 1. So you still get m square. Now we masukkan into the formula. 1 over 1 minus m square. Okay, look at this. This one, anything we can solve. Ada yang boleh diselesaikan. 1 cannot minus the m square, correct? Okay, so cannot minus means you leave it. Tapi remember, if you have what is that? Unknown. Okay, ada huruf yang tidak diketahui diletakkan di denominator means, okay, you must write M tak sama dengan apa. You must write that thing. Okay, or M square. In this case, this is M square. So, teacher, how do I know? What should I write there? Okay, you put like this. 1 minus M square, you jadikan dia sama dengan kosong. Okay, you make it equal to 0. Okay, then we carry what is m square. So the m square teacher bring go there. So it's positive m square. So now that means your m square, kalau dia jadi satu, okay, if your m square jadi satu, so like this, 1 minus 1. What will happen to your denominator? Satu tolak satu akan jadi apa? Kosong, isn't it? Become zero, right? So cannot like that. Your penyebut cannot have zero. So always remember this denominator, okay, penyebut lah, cannot have the value of zero. So now that means you can put m square tak boleh jadi satu. So you cannot ganti that as satu. So usually this is very important. Mesti tulis together. Then only they give you the full dua markah. Sometimes it has to be taken in consideration if that year the marking system is very strict. Okay, so make sure remember this. So 2 marks is very simple question. Ni soalan yang senang lah.